Nice. That was a pretty little reverse he threw right there. Y'all motherfuckers didn't get into this shit.
That's it for the first quarter. The Magic up by 7. Stay with us for more NBA on ESPN after this short break.
Come on. Coaches are evaluating you. Stay active and play as one. Okay. Coaches are evaluating again.
Orlando's leading Utah by a score of 17-10. Slams it in.
Oh, that's a sweet finish right there. Dunking the ball with strength and force.
Hey, Jeff, one of the real surprises last year was the play of Rudy Gobert. This guy has a chance to be a real defensive force.
I think he will win Defensive Player of the Year at some point in his career, Mike. I think his size, his length, his timing, and intensity in combination makes him an elite-level defender. And when he went in the lineup and Cantor got traded, it turned the tide for the Utah Jazz. I see them in the playoffs.
The Jazz with control on the rebound. Flips it up. Shot won't go.
Utah's not.
Wow, these guys are screwing up now. Throwing a pass while he's turning around away from you. And of course, they take me out the game. And I didn't even do anything wrong.
Layup won't go.
Utah's just not set the right tone defensively. They're getting absolutely obliterated on that end of the floor.
Get us back and get me back in the game, because I mean, granted, we're kicking their ass right now, but still.
Burke into the front court. There's the pick. Jeff, because they haven't been in the playoffs, Gordon Hayward does not get the recognition, but this young man is something special.
He is. Let's face it, Utah made a huge investment in Gordon Hayward. And it was really about what they saw in him potential-wise versus what he had already accomplished. They didn't make the playoffs, but he had a good year. And listen, when you're a small market team like Utah, you can't let good players just walk away for nothing. They signed him, they matched Charlotte's offer, and it was a really good move by Dennis Lindsay.
They're going to have to keep creating and start making to work their way back into this game.
Carr for three. Oh, he throws it down. Carr for two. Third quarter comes to an end. Fourth quarter coming up. The Magic up by 12.
Yeah.
We'll be right back with more basketball here on ESPN.
Last second shot. We'll get this one. Your timing is solid. Okay, good, good, good.
As we move on to the fourth quarter, the coach has been angry all night. He has just not been happy with what he's seen.
No, and he's trying to inspire a greater effort because he knows that a couple baskets in a row gets him back into a working deficit.
and he is trying to inspire them not to give in and give up.
Misses for two.
Since you're going to let me in, I mean, I'm going to take it if you let me get it.
Sometimes the simplest plays are the hardest ones.
Oops, backcourt.
Good way.
Oh, goes across the line. Backcourt violation. Frank Vogel's making a few substitutions.
All right.
Screen set nicely. To adjust, nicely done. Gobert the rebound.
I just love the way people are bouncing off of him as he goes up and snags the ball.
You gotta be kidding me, folks.
To the rim. Can't bring it home.
I like it. I'm seeing more effort in the last couple of minutes than we saw in the first half. It may not result in a win here tonight, but the effort is something they can build on going forward.
Ball loose again. He loses control of it. Orlando's leading Utah by a score of 59-41. Hits for two. He's averaging 18 points per game this season.
Again, that's another example of quality NBA offense. Moving the ball, searching the open man out, and then finally, knocking it in.
Hayward on the drive.
Hold him down, hold him down. I can't believe he hit that shot.
Consistency is the hardest thing to achieve in this league. You see how he shot last game? Very poorly. Today, bounced back with a strong effort.
Throws down the dunk. That's a 12-4 run for the Magic.
Pretty dunk there.
And Quinn Snyder calls timeout. Right now, his team's searching for answers.
I don't understand the timeout management here. You need to try to keep the game within striking distance. Instead, they allow him to go on this big run to run up this huge lead, and now they take their timeout.
Really? Put me on the bench? Probably did. I mean,
Dante Exum with the bucket.
Good execution. Wide open 2-point J. Easy money.
Yeah, he can't hang anymore.
Nah, he can't.
Mm-hmm. moves into the paint, throws it back.
Oh, with the nice block.
Out, and this game is over. The final score is 70-49. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Green saying thanks for watching and good night.
Got myself right in the mix here.
Hey everyone, it's Jalen Rose, and it's time for the EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Magic got the win with a comfortable scoring margin. The scoring display they put on is going to be hard to forget. It's hard to imagine anyone doesn't come away impressed with how effectively they scored their points. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored for the Orlando Magic.
Not bad, not bad. Me and Aaron Gordon did it. Oh, yeah, it was pretty close. 13, 14, 15
points. Couldn't put it
together
to get the victory here today. The poor shooting from long range is what held them back. And yet they insisted on chucking up three. That's how you end up with highlights like the ones in this pack. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored. But the Utah Jazz.
Game drive. Defense.
Todd Jazz gave up a bunch of blocks, and they gave up a bunch of steals. That would tell anyone that they didn't deserve to win this game. And that's exactly what happened.
Player of the game.
It wasn't me.
Nikola Vucevic was a unanimous after today's performance. Let's check out
I knew
stats.
It was Nikola Vucevic because it was not me for sure. Not the player of the game this time. I spread that ball around this time.
What can you say about a guy like this? Except that he missed the title of this segment. He was definitely cold in this game.
Yeah, 1-for-12, 2 points, no threes.
These are the top plays of the
yeah,
game.
I would say so.
Number 3. Number 2. Number 1.
Nice.
NBA score. Just for you. On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose. We look forward to seeing you again next time.
See. It was some block parties out there. Okay. Good. Wasn't doing too bad out there. Man, I